Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today I'm going to walk you through the process to swap out our prop shaft seals on our Mercury Tracker 40. Not that tough to do. Let me show you the parts I'm going to use to do this and we'll dive into it. Alright guys, not to scare you, but what I've decided to do is order an entire seal kit because there are several different videos that we're going to do. And this kit really addresses every single seal and gasket that's associated with this particular lower unit. If you want to be sure that yours is ready to go for the whole season, go ahead and order this kit and do the whole thing. And if you need help doing that, if you would, reference this particular unit's playlist and I can walk you through each procedure. So, whether or not you've just got a couple of parts or the whole kit, let's open up the toolbox and dive into this. Let's start off by draining the fluid out of it. That way we won't make quite such a mess. It's just about finished draining. Let's go ahead and start pulling it apart. And the housing is just held in place by two 13 millimeter half inch bolts, one at the top, one at the bottom. So the next step is to actually pull this housing out. And it's going to be in there fairly strong, so you're going to need a decent puller. There's a couple of different ones out there, the slide hammers. You just need to make sure whatever you're using has fingers that can actually wrap around right there in two locations to pull it out. I'm actually using one from Yamaha made for some of their smaller displacement outboards. Works pretty well. That was a little unnerving. Never a good sign when you open up a housing and a piece of metal falls into the drain tray. Don't see any missing teeth. Because now is when you need to check out the bearings, make sure they're still good to go. I mean, if you feel any crunchiness, you've got a problem in there. But these feel really good. All the needles are still in place on that one. So all we're going to replace is just the O-ring and this inner and outer seal right at the output shaft. And when you're doing this, don't go into the housing and gouge it. If so, then you're going to create a potential leak. So we want to go in and pull back just a little bit and then pry in. All right, let's get a little bit bigger screwdriver in here. There's one. Grab the other one. Woohoo! Fun stuff. Now we do want to clean this out a little bit, and you also want to make sure that there's not any corrosion going down, because if it's got a bunch of corrosion, that means it's not going to seal up right, and that's the name of the game here. But this has been a freshwater motor from what I can tell, so it's not really going to be an issue. But if you've been running yours in salt, you really need to pay attention to that. So the way these go back in, small one goes in first like this, and then that one will be resting above it. Aluminum drivers, and we're looking for one that of course will fit on the inside like this, but not so far that it's pushing in on here. We want to push out to that outer edge just as much as possible without going past it. And that 32 millimeter I think is going to do the trick. Now you want to make sure that you're using a piece of wood against this gear because they're very hard, and that also makes them very brittle and easy to damage. We're going to put a little bit of thread locker. On our seal. And yes, I realize it's not a thread, but one of the properties of thread lockers is also a sealant. And they're actually, I think the right word is anaerobic. They don't really activate except in the absence of air. So once you drive it in, that's when it starts to do what it needs to do. The trick is here to get it to go in square. If you sense that it's going in a little cattywampus, angle it to where it'll line it back up right. All right, one down, one to go. Let's get this one started out here. should be it. Now, when you're replacing the O-ring, inspect the groove, make sure there's no corrosion in there. That's typically one of the places it occurs. And we're going to take a little bit of grease, fill that groove back in. Don't really have to fill it in, just want a light coating of it in there. Get our new O-ring in place. A little bit more grease on it. And last but not least, we want to pack the area in between our two seals with grease. So let's go and get our prop shaft installed and get that housing bolted up, and then we'll pretty much be done. Let's go. Next, let's prep our bolts with some red thread locker. You don't have to get carried away, just a little bit on the tip will be all that is required. And then we're gonna torque these to 18 foot-pounds. I'm actually off a little bit on the alignment, so let's tap this over. There we go. Well, all right, guys, that's pretty much going to wrap this one up. The only thing you have left to do is, of course, remount your prop and then refill the lower unit gear lube. Now, if you need help doing that, why don't you reference the playlist for this particular unit and I can walk you through. Listen, if you need these parts or any other parts for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, you like what you see? Go ahead and hit that subscribe button. That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.